آمين. له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا، وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا، صلى الله وملائكته والصالحون من خلقه كما وحد الله وعرف به ودعا إليه. أما بعد، today I thought just to talk about a very important topic which plays a big role. For a very long time I haven't taken the bus, and for a couple of years I think today was my day back to taking the bus, to the bus today. And while I was on the bus I had a book with me that I was reading. Normally when you drive you don't get the chance to read. So I had the chance to read today, and I was reading a book. Wallahi, a very beneficial book, haqiqatan. And every time I read it, it feels like it's the first time, seriously. It's the Imam Al-Allamah Ibn Al-Qayyim Al-Jawziyyah, his kitab, Ighathatu Al-Lahfan Fi Masayid Al-Shaytan. This book is a very powerful book, haqiqatan. And I thought it would be very selfish of me to read this beneficial points and not share with my brothers. So I thought, inshallah, bidnillah, today I can share the powerful words that Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah uses here. My Shaykh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon him and give him a cure. Shaykh Al-Allama, Ishaq Al-Hawini rahimahullah, hafidhahullah ta'ala. You can still say rahimahullah, everybody needs a rahimahullah. Like in Hayyul Yurzaq, he's still alive. He used to say that the kalam in this book, yastahiq, and yaktubu bima'idah. Each word in this book deserves to be written in the ink of gold, each and every one of it, that the Shaykh uses in his book. So inshallah, what I'm going to do is, inshallah, is I'm not going to take any word out. I'm going to explain what's in the book as much as I can from today. And inshallah, I want all of you, inshallah, to share it with me. Ikhwani, Ibn Al-Qayyim starts the first bab of the kitab. He mentions the inqisam. Inqisam al-qulub. The types of qalb there are. The qulub are three types. Every human being who walks on this earth, his qalb is one of these three brothers. Everybody. You look at yourself today, don't let anybody assess you, assess yourself. Ask yourself, which qalb am I from these three? He starts off the strongest qalb, he says, the first qalb is qalb al-sahih, salim. It's the qalb that is cured, fully. Let the definition of Ibn al-Qayyim come into place. He defines it to be لَيْسَ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ قُبُولِ الْحَقِّ. There is nothing between him and accepting the truth, except and loving it and going to strive to it. There's nothing between that. سِوَ إِدْرَاكُ, and until he finds out. That's all he needs. There's nothing between him and the haqq except knowing it. The minute he finds out the haqq, that's it. He jumps on it. That's all he was waiting for. فَهُوَ الصَّحِيحُ الْإِدْرَاكُ. This heart is cured and it's authentic in understanding. تَامُ الْإِنْقِيَادِ وَالْقُبُولِ. It has complete submission and following. That's the قَلْبُ الصَّحِيحُ. Full, he didn't say naqis. Complete. All it needs to hear is that dalil. There you see him takes it. He goes with it. One of my shaykhs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy also upon him. He learned a hadith. The hadith that he learned was that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Salatu al-rajul alladhi yalbisu imama. The salat that the man wears the imama is better than the salat that the person who doesn't wear the imama on the head, 70,000 times better. This is the hadith my Shaykh came across. So he said, I acted upon it for 3 years. I was acting upon it, upon this hadith. That he used to take his bicycle every day. He used to ride a bicycle and come to the masjid with the imam on. He said, when I found that the hadith is da'if, he said, I threw it. But from me there, I understood that he heard the dalil, he took it straight away. He found that it was in sahih, he left it. That is the people whose qalb are sahih. They don't debate when you tell them the truth. They're not argumentative. They find out, their heart is twit their mind. Because you know what, brothers? The heart was already in place. It was already there, intact. All it needed is to hear it, that's it. What about the second qalb? And the qalb al-sahih is in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, yawma, a day, la yanfa' malun wa la banun. Wallahi, a day where money will not benefit you, brothers. Wallahi, you can have as much children as you want, they will not benefit you. Illa man ata Allah bi qalbi salim. Except the person who comes with this heart that we mentioned. Salim, pure. That qalb, whoever comes with it, is beneficial that day. You can have 70,000 kids if you want. You can be the most richest person in the world. If you don't have this qalb, you haven't gained anything. Then the Shaykh wanted to mention in the second part, the second qalb is qalbul mayyit. The first qalb, ikhwani, it has two things. The Shaykh says that first qalb is what the qalb of the Salaf were like. Everything that they wanted to do, ma min fi'latin wa in sagurat illa yunsharu laha diwanan. Lima wa kayfa. How and why? Lima fa'alta wa kayfa fa'alta. The person whose heart is there, everything he does, he asks himself, who am I doing it for? And how am I going to do it? For whose sake am I doing it for? The jawab is ikhlas. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهُ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Everything he does it with sincerity. He knows the call of Sufyan al-Thawri. مَا عَالَجْتُ شَيْئًا أَشَدُّ عَلَيَّ مِن نِيَّتِي. Wallahi, I didn't fight with anything more harder for me than my intention. It's hard. فَوَيَوْمُ لَكَ وَيَوْمُ عَلَيْكَ. One day it's yours, and one day it's not yours. It's against you. It's showing off. Have sincerity and ikhlas. ولذلك الإمام السيوطي جلال الدين السيوطي في كتاب التدريب الراوي. He says, من استطاع, which is the second one, وكيف فعلت, and how are you going to do it? He said, and I want you to all ponder on this. He said, من استطاع منكم أن يحق رأسه إلا بدليل فليفعل. If that one of you can scratch his head with evidence, please do so. Don't hesitate, look for a delete, scratch your head. Don't do anything. وَإِن كَبُرَتْ أَوْ صَغُرَتْ. As big as it is or as small as it is, don't do it if you don't have evidence for it. Who preceded you in this action? And then you find the evidence and follow it. This is the two things that they worked around the people's قلب السليمة. Ikhlas, sincerity. The second thing is that they followed the Prophet in it. The Salaf Ridwanullahi alayhim, as Imam ibn Sa'd in his Tabaqat, he mentioned that Maymun ibn Mihran, and wallahi it's sad, I really feel sad when I see, if one of us are very ill today, 2 days, we go to the hospital, GP, we call our GP, we want to come, can we have a checkup, something's not right. When our qalb becomes tainted, what do? We don't go. We don't look for it. The Prophet, when the man, he asked the people after his head, had a wound on it, he said to the people, أَتَجِدُوا لِيَ الرُّخْصَةَ. Can you find for me a way out? I mean, I got a wound, I can't have a wudu, I can't have a bath, a ghusl. Can you find me a rukhsa? قَالُوا لَا نَجِدُ لَكَ. They gave fatwa. What did the Prophet say to them when they told him the story? He said, قَتَلْتُمُوا قَتَلَكُمُ اللَّهُ. You killed him, may Allah kill you guys. أَلَمْ تَسْأَلُوا إِذَا لَمْ تَعْلَمُوا. Why didn't you ask if you didn't know? إِنَّمَا شِفَاءُ الْعِي أَسْسُؤَالِ. The cure to ignorance is question. Cure. So ignorance is an illness. The Prophet says, شِفَاء. إِنَّمَا شِفَاءُ الْعِي أَسْسُؤَالِ. We have that ignorance in our hearts. That illness. Do we look for the cure? Look what Maymun ibn Mihran did. Maymun ibn Mihran was the katib to Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Kafahu sharafan wa makana. That is enough for him. That he used to only write for Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. وكان Umar ibn Abdul Aziz لا يقرب إلا الأفاضل. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz never used to bring anybody close to him except the righteous people. خليفة الخامس كما يقال. He was the fifth khalifa. He never used to bring anyone close to him except the righteous people. Maymun and Mihran were the writer for him. وَجِدَ فِي قَلْبِهِ يَوْمًا. He found in his heart one day, a bit, he changed. It wasn't as he used to be. He went. Brothers, look at these people. They found out that their iman wasn't the way it was. They questioned themselves. Khabab ibn al-Arad and Abu Bakr said, wallahi, no. When we're the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he speaks to us about the Jannah and the Naar, كَأَنَّنَا رَرَاهُ بِأَعْلِمِنَا. It's like we can see the Jannah and the Naar. Our iman is there. فَإِذَا تَصَاحَفْنَا أَزْوَاجَنَا. When we come back to our children and our families and we stay with them, we forget everything. They realize, brothers, that things changed. In the majlis of the Messenger, this is the way the iman was. Then outside, this is the way it was. The Prophet said, as-sa'atu as-sa'a. Time. لَوْ كُنْتُمْ كَمَا تَكُونُونَ عِنْدِي لَسَافَحْتُكُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ أي في الطرقات. If you guys were the way you are with me everywhere, the angels would come down and they would shake your hands. Assalamu alaikum. Mahalu shahid, brothers, is the angels, the righteous people, they realize when their iman is not there, they go, they fetch help, support. Because that is the most important part in their body for them. So when Maymun came, he said to his son, وَفِقْ قِصَّةً. In the story we can realize, Maymun, he called his son, he said, يَا بُنَيْ قُودُونِي إِلَى حَسَنَ الْبَصْرِ. Take me by the hand and take me to Hassan al-Basri. هَذَا مِنِّي لَعَلِي أَكُونُ خَاطِئًا فِيهِ. Something I assumed, I might be wrong in it, that Maymun ibn Mihran may have lost his eyesight. To ask his son to take him to Hassan al-Basri. So he opened, knocked on the door. فَلَمَّا دَقَّ عَلَى الْبَابِ. When he knocked on the door, the wife of Hassan al-Basri came. Who's Hassan al-Basri? حافظ الذهب إن كتب سير على منه بلا ينسى. حسن البصري كأنه رجل ذهب إلى الآخرة وعاينها ورجع ليخبر الناس عنها. حسن البصري was like his door person went to the آخرة. He saw جنة النار and everything and he came back to tell the people about it. In another place he said about حسن البصري رحمه الله تعالى. He said كلامه ككلام الأنبياء. He's the way he spoke was just like the speeches of the prophets. قليل في ألفاظه قوي في معانيه. Small in the structure, immense in the meaning. He's the man who said, he said, وَإِن طَقْطَقَتْ بِهِمُ الْبِغَالِ وَأَمْلَجَتْ بِهِمُ الْبَرَادِينَ فَإِنَّ الذُّلَّ لَا تُفَرِّقُوا وُجُوهَهُمْ أَبَى اللَّهُ إِلَّا أَنْ يُذِلَّ مَنْ عَصَاهُ. Hassan al-Basri. Whatever they do, however they try, and wherever they go, and however much they try to go against the qadr and Allah was written for them, Allah refused. سبحانه وتعالى إلا أن يذل من عصى. To belittle and put down the person of disobedience. That's Hassan al-Basri. That's the way he used to talk. Powerful words. So when they came to Hassan al-Basri, he came to Hassan, his wife opened the door. She said, man, who? And he said, Mihran. She said, Ya Shaykh al-Su, ما أبقاك في هذا الزمن السوء. You indecent individual. What made you stay at this indecent time? That time? Imagine today. The turuq, the shawarib, tuhur, sometime when you walk. He cried. فَبَكَى حَتَّى أُخْشِيَ عَلَيْهِ. He cried until he fainted again. So they brought him to the house. Hassan al-Basri, he said to him, Ya Hassan. He said, Ya Aba Sa'id. That was the kunya of Hassan al-Basri. He said, إِنِّي أَجِدُ فِي قَلْبِي ضَعُفًا. I find in my heart weakness. أَفَأَصُومُ لَهَا. Shall I fast? What shall I do? He said, قال الله تعالى أَفَرَأَيْتَ إِن مَتَّعْنَاهُمْ سِنِينَ ثُمَّ جَاءَهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُعَدُونَ مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُمَتَّعُونَ فَبَكَى مَيْمُونُ مِنْ مَهْرَانِ. مَيْمُونُ cried. فَأُوشِي عَلَيْهِ. Hassan said, أُخُرُجُوهُ مِنْ بَيْتِي. Take him out of my house now. أَفَرَأَيْتَ. Do you not see? إِن مَتَّعْنَاهُمْ سِنِينَ. If we give them the joy of the world for a little bit. ثم after that, ثم جاءهم ما كانوا يوعدون. And then it comes to them what has been promised for them, the hereafter, the Jannah and the Naar, everything is brought. ما كانوا. And ثم جاءهم ما كانوا يوعدون. ما أغنى عنهم ما كانوا يوعدون. It will not help them. That which has been given to them, the joy that they had, the mata' that they had, will not help them from what Allah has promised, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This story has a lot of fawaid. Mallahu bihi alim. Allah knows. One of the fa'ida is Hassan cured the heart issue that was in her heart with the ayat of the Quran. Ya ayyuhan nasu qad ja'akum min Allahi nurun wa kitabun mubin yahdi bihi Allahu man ittaba ridwanahu. The Quran is a shifa lima fi sudur. It's a cure to the heart. The qalb al-salim, ikhwan, is cured with this. The qalb is like this. As-alu Allah an yaj'alana minhu. The second qalb, ikhwan, is a mayyit, dead. It's dead. What is it? La hayata lahu. Ibn al-Qayyim says no life to it. فَوَا لَا يَعْرِفُ رَبَّهُ. He doesn't even know his Lord. وَلَا يَعْبُدُهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. He doesn't worship Allah with his orders. وَمَا يُحِبُّهُ. He doesn't love Allah. وَيَرْضَاهُ. He's not pleased with Allah Azza wa Jalla. بَلْ هُوَ وَاقِفٌ مَعَ شَهَوَاتِهِ وَلَذَّاتِهِ. This person is on the top of his desires and his was sweet for him. Rasul loves. وَلَوْ كَانَ فِيهَا سَخَطُ رَبِّهِ. And if in there was the anger of his Lord, meaning if Allah hates this, وَغَضَبُهُ فَهُوَ لَا يُبَالِي بِهَا. He doesn't care. If Allah loves it, if Allah hates it, doesn't really matter to him. قَلْبٌ مَيِّت. He's dead. He's more into the dunya. He's more about his money, his car. That's what matters to him. Today's hot. I'm going to look after my car today. I'm going to wash my car. I'm going to make sure my car is beautiful. I'm going to make sure my living room is beautiful. My balcony looks nice. I'm going to make sure we can do a good, the garden looks nice. This is my goal. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah then said, فَهُوَ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَمَا قِيلَ فِي اللَّيْلَى. He's like the dunya as it was said about Layla. A man loved Layla so much. He loved her so much. Because he loved Layla, look what he said. He said, عَدُوٌ لِمَنْ عَادَتْ وَسِلْمٌ لِأَهْلِهَا. Meaning, I'm an enemy to whoever she's an enemy to. Because his love is for her, right? So he only loves who she loves. وَسِلْمٌ لِأَهْلِهَا. And she's only happy. He's only happy with who she's happy with. That's what he is. He's only loving the dunya. He's only happy with what the dunya has. وَمَنْ قَرَّبَتْ لَيْلَى أَحَبَّ وَأَقْرَبَى. Anybody who gets closer to Layla, I get closer to him and I love him. Anybody who gets closer to the dunya, he loves him. Anybody who's like him, who's got cars, that's the person he loves. He only looks at people who's richer than him. He never looks at the person who's got more piety than him. More iman and taqwa from him. هذا قلب ميت إخوان. He's dead. That person is dead. Ibn al-Qayyim then says, فَمُخَالَطَةُ صَاحِبُ هَذَا الْقَلْبِ. For you to sit and to take time with that individual, سَقَمُ. It's an illness. وَمُعَاشَرَتُهُ سُمِّن. And you sitting with him is a disease. It's poisonous. Sitting with a person like that. وَمُجَالَسَةُ هَلَاك. And gathering and sitting in his gathering, إخوان, is destruction. Leave that individual alone. Don't hang around with a person whose qalb is mayyit. The third qalb. And this is the one that the majority of the Muslims fall under. إِلَّا مَرْحِمَ اللَّهُ. قَلْبٌ مَرِيِّد. This person's qalb is ill. فَلَهُ حَيَاتٌ وَبِهِ عِلَّةٌ. He has a life, but then he also has the illness. فَلَهُ مَادَّتَانِ. He has two subjects, two things inside it. تَمُدُّهُ هَذِهِ مَرَّةٌ. One time he's got life, he's got iman. وَهَذِهِ أُخْرَى. And sometimes he has the other one. Sometimes you see him in the masjid, durus, halaqat, he's praying in the salah, raq'at, every... وَرْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. Later, he's walking in the street, he sees somebody else, he's with that person, he's that person's religion, he's with that individual. What's making this person like this? Look what Allamah Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says. فَفِيهِ مِن مَحَبَّةِ اللَّهِ. He loves Allah. وَالْإِيمَانِ بِهِ. He has iman of Allah. وَالْإِخْلَاصِ لَوْ. He has a sincerity in him, this person. وَالْتَوَكُّلِ عَلَيْهِ. And he has tawakkul in Allah. That is why his heart is alive. That's only what he can be alive with. There's a little sparks. This is, why has he got the other part? Why is it memorial? Why is it ill? Because he has this one. وَفِيهِ مِن مَحَبَّةِ الشَّهَوَاتِ. He loves desires. وَإِثَارِهَا. He strives for it. His life is what? His desires. وَالْحِرْسِ عَلَى تَحْسِيلِهَا. He always wants to get what his desires cause him to. وَالْحَسَدْ. He's an envious individual. وَالْكِبْرُ. Arrogance. وَالْعُجْبُ. He's always fascinated with himself. وَحُبُّ الْعُلُوِّ وَالْفَسَادِ. He wants to be higher than the rest of the people. and he wants destruction for the others. He wants ri'asa, leadership. If two, five people sit down, the brothers, you know what? I'm going to rule you guys, okay? I'll be a leader. That's what he loves. مَا هُوَ مَادَّةُ هَلَاكِي This is why the destruction is in him. So he has those running beside each other. Sometimes, the tawakkul and the mahabba and the iman goes stronger, and this goes a bit weaker. And sometimes this one goes up, and this one goes a bit down. So it's always like that. مُذَبْذَبِينَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكِ It's always between this one. لَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ وَلَا إِلَهَا أُولَاءِ He's not with this one fully, knows he with this one. He's got one leg there and one leg there. We take this box, the majority of us. 5 days, we're in the masjid, durus, halaqah, masajid, ta'if. Fajr. Looking at all your faces. You're all close to the area, majority of you. Close. Who really comes to the fajr in this masjid and prays at the first line or two? Little you find somebody who comes fajr and prays and says to his family, I'm leaving. That nice warm bed, he leaves it. That is a person whose qalb is strong. That he can fight his desires. He can push his desires away. Why? Because he has his desires in control. Where's the other one? Lala. It's vice versa. He can't control himself. The desires controls him. So if his desire says to him, now we're not going to go Fajr today. He's like, okay. I'm going to stay today, inshallah. I'll go tomorrow. Desire says, no, not even tomorrow. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he mentioned the three is in these ayat of Surah Al-Hajj. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. All the three we mentioned is in these ayat of the Qur'an. In Surah Al-Hajj, ayah 52 to ayah 54, you find the three that we mentioned. Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولِ وَلَا نَبِيٍّ إِلَّا إِذَا تَمَنَّى أَلْقَى الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَّتِهِ فَيَنْسَخُ اللَّهُ مَا يُلْقِي الشَّيْطَانُ ثُمَّ يُحْكِمُ اللَّهُ آيَاتِهِ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ First one we're going to find out. لِيَجْعَلَ مَا يُلْقِي الشَّيْطَانُ فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ One. وَالْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ لَفِي شِقَاقٍ بَعِيدٍ وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ The one whose qalb is salim, here he is. وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ And remember what Allah mentioned, the people's qalb are salim. This is what the characteristic they have. وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ They were given knowledge. أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ Two things Allah mentioned here. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions them both. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them idraakul shay. They recognized this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave them what? وَقُوَّةِ تَنْفِيذِ Allah gave them the ability to do what they see is right. Two bad, two strong things. The two things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the last ayat in Surah Al-Fatiha. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ The Nasara, they have one missing. Which is what? They have no knowledge, their actions. See, they don't have the ilm. So they act without knowledge. Nasara have, Yehud have what? Ilm. Do they have actions? La. The people's qalb are salim, they have the two. إِدْرَاكُ الشَّيْءَ عَلَى مَا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ إِدْرَاكًا جَازِمًا Knowing something the way it is with certainty. So they don't have no doubt, no shak, no rape. And what do they have? كَنْفِيذِهِ They can also accomplish what they know. Some people, mashallah, they know. They say, this is haram. I know the khamr is haram. I even know what ayah number it is. I know the hadith, where they're written in. I know it. But you can't do it. So he's missing the other part, which is what? تَنْفِيذِ وَلِذَلَكَ سُفْيَانَ الثَّوْرِي He said, مَا فَسَدَ مِنْ عُبَادِنَا Any one of our worshippers who go wrong, فَفِيهِ شَبَهُ مِنَ النَّصَارَى He has the characteristics of the characteristics of the Nasara. Because the worshipper, the worships of Allah, there's not much knowledge. And the ones, فَسَدَ مِنْ عُلَمَائِنَا The scholars that go wrong, فَفِيهِ شَبَهُ مِنَ الْيَهُودِ There's a characteristic of the Yehud, because the Yehud have knowledge and they... Allah mentioned them both. Look what he says. وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ فَيُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ And we said إيمان القول والعمل. They have the actions. Allah, what did he say? فَتُخْبِتَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبُهُمْ أَيَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ Their qalb becomes tranquil. Because they have the knowledge and they have the tanfeed. They can make it happen. Allah then says, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَهَدِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ Allah guides those people, those ones that we mentioned in the Quran, to the right path. Because they have the knowledge and the strive, of course Allah is going to guide them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa mentioned in the hadith, where Imam Muslim narrated, and I want to show you again the division of the hearts. Hudhayfah ibn Yamani said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ We have to know, ikhwana, our hearts, it's presented, it's in a way, it's made in a way where the problem is always going to come to it. It's upon us to stop the problem from coming to affecting it. And the Prophet mentions this to us. He says, تُعْرَضُ الْفِتْنَةِ, the trials and the tribulations, they will be presented عَلَى الْقُلُوبِ, to the hearts. كَعَرْضِ الْحَصِيرُ عُودًا عُودًا, it will be presented to us twig after the other. That's how it goes on. عُودًا عُودًا فَأَيُّ قَلْبٍ, any heart, أُشْرِبَهَا, that swallows it, that takes it, نُكِتَتْ فِيهِ نُكْتَةٌ سَوْدًا, any heart that accepts the sin, who takes it in, his heart has one black dot. Get a white paper and do a dot on it. And then do another dot. Keep doing dot, 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 dot. At the end of the day, what happens? It becomes fully black. وَأَيُّ قَلْبٍ, the قَلْب, أَنْكَرَهَا. So what does that show you? That the fitna was always thrown at it. But he's strong enough, when the fitna comes, he throws it away. أَنْكَرَهَا نُكِتَتْ فِيهِ نُكْتَةً بَيْضًا. Instead of a black dot, his heart is even made more whiter. He has a white dot. It's made clean. Much cleaner than it was. حَتَّى تَعُودَ الْقَلْبُ, until the qalb becomes عَلَى قَلْبَيْن, two qalb. Allahu Akbar. قَلْبٌ, قَلْبٍ, sorry. عَلَى قَلْبَيْن, قَلْبٍ أَسْوَدَ, black qalb. مُرْبَادًا كَالْكُوزِ مُجَخِّيًا, it becomes like a charcoal, as dark as a charcoal. And it becomes a cup, you know, a cup. If a cup is put down and water is poured in it, does it go something? Does anything go in it? That's how it becomes. It's like pouring water in a cup that face is facing down. And it's that black charcoal. لَا يَعْرِفُ مُعْرُوفًا, he doesn't know the good. وَلَا يُنْكِرُ مُنْكَرًا, he can't recognize. He said, brothers, again, what I mentioned before. وَلْيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ, what's missing from them? They can't realize the haqq. إِدْرَاكُ الْعِلْمِ, to recognize this, they don't even know. How many people do you see? They don't even know what they're in is a fitna. ولذلك إمام الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية said something قوي. والله بكلام. He said, علماء أهل السنة, the people of the sunnah, يعرفون الحق, يعرفون الفتنة قبل وقوعه. The people of the sunnah and the haqq, they know the problem before it comes. They can see it. Not that they know the غيبيات. Not that they know unseen. But because they know the haqq, and the haqq is so clear to them, they know what's coming is going to be a fitna. Brothers, don't go there. Wallahi, it's a fitna. As for the people who are the juhal, the ignorant people, يَعْلَمُونَ الْفِتْنَةَ, they recognize the fitna بَعْدَمَا يَتَوَلَّى, and when the fitna goes and he turns his back. He doesn't recognize while he's in it. وَلِذَلِكَ الْمَقْمُ أُمْرُ قَيْسِ, he said his kalam which is ma'roof, الْفِتْنَةَ أَوَّلُ مَا تَكُونُ فَتِيَّتِهِ تَسْعَى بِزِينَتِهَا لِكُلِّ جَهُولِ حَتَّى إِذَا اشْتَطَّ وَضَمَّتْ ذِرَاعُهَا. The fitna is like a woman, a young girl, fresh, young. When she first comes, everybody looks at her, mashallah, beautiful. The fitna is beautiful when it first comes. When the person dresses inside it, she becomes old, like an old woman. شَمَّتْ, she becomes old, her skin becomes old. وَضَمَّتْ, and her cheeks and everything goes down. You don't want to touch her, you don't want to hug her, nothing to do with her. At the beginning, she was beautiful, young, fresh, young girl. The Salaf used to say, this shi'r, this bait that I mentioned, they used to say, Hassan al-Basri, Awza'i, Abdullah ibn Mubarak, Ma'mar ibn Rashid, Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-San'ani, they all said, yastahiq an yuhfaz, deserves to be memorized. It's poetry. Bukhari, rahimahullah, if you go Kitab al-Fitan, Kitab al-Fitan, Bukhari brings this hadith. This poetry of Umar Qais, memorization, deserves to be memorized. So the qalb will not recognize the fitna, brothers. If it's dark and it's like that cup that's twisted, you water, pour water in it, it doesn't recognize anything. Let's see the other one. The second one is وَقَلْبٌ أَبْيَضٌ, a qalb which is white. فَلَا تَضُرُّهُ فِتْنَةٌ, the fitna doesn't trouble him. مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, forever and ever, no fitna troubles him. He's always in good. He has shields, things that are going to protect him. Ikhwani, if your qalb is going to be protected, you might think to yourself, no, but my body might be good. La, we'll say to you, إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنٌ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنٌ وَبَيْنَهُمَ أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَةٌ لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ. فمن اتقى الشبهات فقد استبرأ لدينه وعرضه، وما وقع في الشبهات وقع في الحرام كالراعي يرعى حول الحمى يوشك أن يرتعى فيه، ألا وإنك بجسد مضغة. إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله، وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله، ألا وهي القلب. There is an organ in your body. If it becomes good and strong, every part of your body is good. Your body follows the king. The king. That's why Abu Huraira said, "Al-mali al-qalb malik al-a'dha." The qalb is the king of the limbs. فَإِنْ طَابَ الْمَلِكُ طَابَتِ الْجُلُودُ وَالرَّعَايَا. The king is good, then the followers and the armies and the people who are with him are always prosperous. وَإِنْ خَبُثَ الْمَلِكُ, if the king is evil, خَبُثَتِ الْجُلُودُ وَالرَّعَايَا. The followers and everybody who follows him, they take that corrupted idea from him. If your king is tainted, is evil, then everything that comes with it will become evil. So you have to look after this qalb. وَلِذَلِكَ what Sa'al ibn Abdullah al-Tustari said, he said, رجل مبيض للثياب. A man, you see him, his garment is so clean. When he comes out on Friday, subhanAllah, he has 7 different fragrances that come out of him. Has a bath. He has his own towel for Friday. Soap, fresh only for Fridays. Comes out. She's a sunnah, no doubt. When he comes out, he walks on the street. You know it's him. You haven't even seen him, but he's well known for this atr that he wears. مُدَنِّسٌ فِي دِينِهِ. His qalb is the most tainted of qalb. Never looks after it. He only looks after his body. And that's why I said, in a lesson that I had yesterday, I said that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, يُؤْتَى بِالرَّجُلِ السَّمِينِ الْبَدِينِ. A man will be brought the day of judgment, who's big, swollen, fat. There's a lot of meat on him. فَيُوضَعُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ. He will be put on the mizan. فَلَا يَزِنُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضًا. To Allah, he's not equal as the wing of a mosquito. Where's all of the weight? Where's all the flesh? Where's all the meat gone? Because the most heaviest thing is the heart. That is the most heaviest thing. It's very light. So the body won't be heavy that day. But we also have to remember one thing, brothers. What comes from the limbs affects what goes to the heart. I mentioned this many occasions. Looking, especially now that we're in this country, the fitna, يَمُوجُ كَمُوجِ الْبَحْرِ. It's like a wave. It's there everywhere. Brothers, wallahi, you have to look after your eyes. You have to put your eyes down. Because looking goes directly to the heart. Your mouth, what you say, goes to your heart. What you listen to affects your heart. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, حق عبد علي بن أبي طالب. He said, يا علي, لا تتبع النظرة على النظر. Don't follow a look with the other look. فإن لك الأولى وليس لك الآخر. The first one is yours, but the second one isn't. Some brothers say, I'm still on my first one. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you look, turn away straight away and never look. You won't be held accountable for the first one because it wasn't deliberately. If you don't, نكتت في قلبه نكتة سوداء. لكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نحدي كلما أذنب عبد ذنبا نكتت في قلبه نكتة سوداء فإن تاب وأناب سقل وبيض قلبه وإلا ران قلبه فتلا قول الله تعالى كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. The messenger said, every time you do a sin, it's a black dot. You looked and you looked again and you looked again. Brothers come up to you and say, Akhi, wallahi, my iman is very low. Na'am, of course it's low. It'll always be low if you can't look after your eyes. It'll always be low if you stop listening to music. It'll always be low if you stop speaking softly towards women. You have to watch your mouth, you have to watch your ears and your eyes. If you do, of course you won't be complaining and coming to us, calling us at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock at night, saying my iman has gone down. People want to quit, and just that minute he thinks he's got hidayah with you. You tell me hadith, I want my iman to increase. Of course, it's the minute I tell you, I put the phone down, an hour later you're going to go out there in the street and start looking around. Look what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the most righteous of women. He said, وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُهُنَّ مَتَاعًا فَاسْأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَاءِ حِجَابٍ ذَلِكُمْ أَطْهَرُ لِقُلُوبِكُمْ وَقُلُوبِهِنْ. Speaking to the women, cover yourselves up. The hats, واجب من الله عز وجل أمرهم من فوق سبع السماوات. Allah ordained upon the women to cover themselves from high above. يا النبي قل لأزواجك وبناتك ونساء المؤمنين يدنين عليهن من جلابيبهن. For the woman to cover herself fully. المرأة كلها عورة. The woman is an awra from every side and every place. She covers herself fully. If she covers herself, what did Allah mention in the ayah after? ذَلِكُمْ أَطْهَرُ. First of all, whose heart does it purify? Yours. Sister who's wearing the hijab. Doesn't matter مَا يَقُولُ زَيْدٌ أَوْ عَمْرٌ أَوْ خَالِدٌ. It doesn't matter what these people have to say. Your قلب will be strong. Because you've hold on to Allah's order. وَقُلُوبِهِنَّ. And the heart of the people will also be good. The heart of the people will also be good. So an action that you do, brothers, can look after your heart. Allah also said in another ayah, يَا نِسَاءَ النَّبِيِّ لَسْتُنَّ كَأَحَدٍ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ إِنِ اتَّخَيْتُنْ فَلَا تَقْطَعْنَ بِالْقَوْلِ فَيَطْمَعَ الَّذِي فِي قَلْبِهِ مَرَضٌ وَقُلْنَ قَوْلًا مَعْرُوفًا. When you speak, the beginning of the ayah, Allah says to the wives of the Prophet, you are not like the rest of the women. You're a role model. The people look up to you. لَسْتُنَّ كَأَحَدٍ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ. You're not like the individual woman. When you speak, don't soften your words. Sister, how you doing? The brother says to the sister. The sister says to the brother, brother, the takhfif can be two ways. Softening the words can be two ways. In the way you say it, and in the words that you use. The way you say it, even if you're saying the most maturest thing, it can destroy the way you put it. And also, if you use the wrong terminologies. You have to watch what you say. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the people whose hearts are ill. It will affect them. He says in the ayah, فَلَا تَخْطَعَنَ بِالْقَوْلِ فَيَطْمَعَ الَّذِي فِي قَلْبِهِ مَرَضٌ. And that word that you said, that came from your mouth, will go to an inner ear of a person whose heart is ill already. He was already 1%. The battery is about to fall. You said soft words to him. Everything went wrong. And then the person has to understand an action that you do on your limb affects what's in your heart, brothers. And it also affects the people who are around you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to test the people's hearts, in an ayah that Ibn al-Qayyim brought, he says, قال تعالى, Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا وَمَا جَعَلْنَا. We haven't made أصحاب النار إلا ملائكة. We haven't made for the people of hellfire except angels. إلا ملائكة وَمَا جَعَلْنَا. Except angels, and we haven't made عِدَّتَهُمْ, the numbers of the angel, إلا فتنة. The numbers of the angels that we've made a fitna. We want to understand what Allah means by this. Fitna. To who? لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The number of angels that Allah is going to mention, which is 19. Abu Lahab, Abu Jahl came. Even though some of the ulama of hadith, they consider the hadith to be da'if. And I think that Rawi, think, was Ismail ibn Ayyash. Some of the ulama considered him to be munkar al-hadith. Anyhow, Abu Jahl came and he said to the people, 19, huh? Leave 18 with me. I'll control the angels. 18. You guys, just 19. You look after the other one. I can take over 18. Oh, you Quraysh, can you not look after one? Look at the believers. When 19 was said to them, they didn't say, Ya Rabbi, why 19 for? Look at the whole wide world, look how many millions of kuffar there are. Why do you just need 19 for? Allah is doing this fitna to see whose iman is strong and who's going to believe in it. Look what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said. لِيَسْتَيْقِنَ الَّذِينَ. So you can have yaqeen. الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ. The ones that have been given the books. وَيَزْدَادَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِيمَانًا. The people who have iman, the iman will increase. Allah is 19. Wallahi, Allah knows what He's going to do, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever Allah says is the truth. It's the haqq. This is what we mentioned at the beginning. All they need to know, the people's qalb as-salim, is to hear the haqq. Allah said it, the messenger said it, الحمد لله we here and obey. والله لك أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه وهو من أروع الأمثلة. The best of examples that we can be from the companions is Abu Bakr. When they told him, يدعي صاحبك أنه قد أسري, your friend, he claims that he's been ascended up in the air. He said, والله لو قال لصدق. والله if he said the truth. سبحان الله. هذا اليقين. Now the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, a Bedouin man came. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wanted to buy something from him. Later the Bedouin man said to the Prophet, you didn't buy it from me. He tricked the Prophet. And he said, you didn't buy nothing from me. He made the Prophet look like he was a liar. The Prophet said, wallahi I did. The man said, no, you didn't. The Prophet looked around and said, wallahi. And the Sahabi stood up. He said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, I'm your witness. I'm your witness that you did. Later the Prophet asked him, witness, how do you? He said, wallahi, you don't lie, Muhammad. Everything you say is the truth. The Prophet said, wallahi shahadatuka ta'dilu shahadatan. Your shahad is equal to two people. He can go by himself and be two witnesses. That's it. Because the day when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some Abadun was pulling him and saying, you're lying. He became a witness for him. The Sahabas were like that. Jilun farid. Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in. How strong they were. They needed to see it, they believed it. A man standing, he said, Ya Rasulullah, what's between me and Jannah? How far is Jannah? He said, the dates that you eat. He didn't say, Ya Rasulullah, come on. He threw it straight away and went to the battlefield. Fought, and he died in the battlefield. He knew that the Prophet said it, kafa. One of the most phenomenal examples that I can come around with. Ukashat ibn Muhsin. The man, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to him, إِنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِي مَنْ يَدْخُلُ 70,000 يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ وَلَا عَذَابٍ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet debated the hadith of Sa'id ibn Jubayr min Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anna Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sahih Muslim, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ وَلَا عَذَابٍ. Sahabas disputed amongst themselves and debated. One person said, لا, إنهم الذين ولدوا في الإسلام. People who are 70,000 are the ones who were born Islam. And that's a virtue that the people who were born as Muslims have. It's a virtue to be born as a Muslim. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, someone said, لا, إنهم الذين صحبوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. They're not. They're the ones who were companions with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And that's always a virtue to be a companion of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. When the Prophet said, what are you debating about? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, هم الذين لا يسترقون. They don't ask for ruqya. ولا يكتوون. They don't burn themselves. ولا يتطيرون. And they're not superstitious. وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. And they do توكل in Allah. عكاش said, يا رسول الله, ادعو الله. Ask Allah. أن يجعلني منهم. So Allah can make me from these 70,000. He said, أنت منهم. You're from them. This great companion, Ukash ibn Muhsin, in one of the ghazawat, he came to the Prophet ﷺ, his sword broke. He said, Ya Rasulullah, mali safe. I don't have no sword. The Prophet took a tree, took off the twigs, and said, fight with us. He didn't say, Ya Rasulullah. It's a real battlefield. He didn't say this. When he looked at the stick of the companions, he took it and he fought with it in the battlefield. People have swords. It's not a joke. It's not a play. He took a twig and he's fighting in the battlefield. That comes from complete submission and belief. All they needed is to choose, hear it from the Prophet. That's it. They believed it. And that's why their hearts were strong. The iman was there. They looked after it. The ayah that Allah mentioned, the people are the four type of people. Those who, when they heard the 19 angels, what came from their heart was kufr, wa takdhib, wa juhud. Hard-headedness. The second type of people is their iman increased. They believed in it more. Because the Quran, all it does for them increases in them more in haq. Well, then you can look at the followers. Look at the followers of Quraysh. When they saw the Prophet ﷺ, the way the companions were like, That's why they said إنه لساحر. He's a magician. The way the Sahabas were like, he's fooled these people. He's took over their brains. إن توضع, if he does wudu, كادوا يقتلون على وضوئي. They are close to fighting over water that he does wudu with. وَإِنَّخَا مُخَامَةً If he spits a spit, إِلَّا وَقَعَتْ عَلَى وَيَدِ رَجُلٍ فَدَلَكَ بِهَا وَجْهُ Except that he falls on the hand of a man's palm, the companions, and he wipes on his face. هَذَا قَدْعَ They said, that's junoon. That's what the Sahaba of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were like. Ikhwani, the human being's body, Ibn al-Qayyim says, four things is what it requires. Wallahi's quwwah of Ibn al-Qayyim, the way he looks at it. Four things a human being needs, he can survive in his body. And he wants to implement these four on the heart. So first, let's implement it on the body. Which is the first one? Hifdhul quwwah. The person's ability should be protected for them. What do we mean by that? We mean by Islam came and he protected your body. For example, if you're a musafir and it's the month of Ramadan, you have what? Rukhsah. فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَمَرَ الْمُسَافِرِ Allah ordered the musafir والمريض أن يُفْطِرُوا فِي رَمَضَانِ You're ill, right? You're traveling. The month of Ramadan is ill. To look after your energy, Allah said, don't break it. Break your fast. So the first thing that's needed is, إخواني, حِفْظُ الْقُوَّةِ To protect the person's ability. The second one is, حِمْيَةَ عَنِ الْمُؤْذِي To protect the person from what's harming them. To barricade and stop the harm coming to this individual. Every doctor has to do this for you when it comes to you. Which is, what did Islam do? Islam stopped harm coming to you, such as what? When you are ill, you are not forced to use water, because it's kind of physically harming. Islam pulled it away from you. Taking away from you anything that might harm you. Are you ill? You wounded? You have to have a bath, the water's cold, don't use it. We don't want to harm you. Anything that's going to harm you, we deflect it from you. Islam's looked after you. وَلَكِ الرَّجُلْ مِنَ السَّلَفِ said, Ya Allah, Ajib, wallahi, the Salaf, the way he looked at the Rahmah of Allah and His mercy. Allah allows you to save yourself to disobey Him. How is that? If you're in a state of pain and somebody forces you to insult Allah just so you can save yourself, Islam has given you rukhsah to say that. This disrespect Allah for your weak existence to live, for you to live. إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ Save yourself. Look how much Allah value He's made for you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you think and you wish to do bad for Him. And this is how much He said to you, Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He's looking after your ability. He's looking after any harm coming your way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deflecting it from you and protecting you from it. The second thing is istifragul madati fasida. The third thing is to take away from you anything that is already there that's harming you. It's already there on you. Take it away. What did Allah say in Surah Al-Baqarah? Wa atimul hajj wal umrah lillah. Until He says, فَمَسْتَيْسَرَ مِنَ الْهَدْيِ وَلَا تَحْلِقُوا رُؤُوسَكُمْ حَتَّى يَبْلُغَ الْهَدْيُ مَحِلَّةً فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ بِهِ أَذًى فَفِدْيَةٌ مِنْ صِيَامٍ أَوْ صَدَقَةٍ أَوْ نُسُكٍ If Hajj, your hair hurts, head, and your hair is on, Allah said, I allow you to take off your hair. Even though Hajj, you shouldn't take off your hair. But because there is adha, Allah says, وَلَا تَحْلِقُوا رُؤُوسَكُمْ Don't cut your hair off. فَمَنْ كَانَ بِهِ أَذَمْ Anybody who has harm with his hair, and he's harming him, take it off. Islam takes the harm away from you, it's already on you. Get rid of it, labas. These three is how a human being, I said four by accident, it's only three. These three, first one is حِفْظُ الْقُوَّةِ is to protect your ability. The second one is حِمْيَةُ عَنِ الْمُؤْذِي is to barricade and stop from you anything that's going to harm you. Drugs. Allah prohibited from you because the harm that's going to come to you. مَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ شَيْئًا فِي دَوَاءُكُمْ Allah did not prohibit something that your cure is in it. كُلَّمَا حَرَّمَهُ فَوَدَاءٌ Everything Allah prohibited, ikhwani, is an illness for you. وَاللَّهِ وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى Allah is the highest example, subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the highest of examples. And until today, qa'imah, when the ummah chose to go, that what the Prophet said. He said, Ya ma'ashara al-ansar. Hadith of Ibn Umar in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Wa sahihun bi mujma'i turuqiha. It came more than 23 turuq. Bit tatabbu'i wal istiqra naqis min indi. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? Ya ma'ashara al-ansar. Khamsu khisalin idha abtulitum bihim. Wa'udhi billah an tudrikuhunna. Lam tadhar al-fahishatu fi qawmin qat. 10. Khamsu khisalin. 5 characteristics. If you're tested with it, and I seek refuge in Allah from these 5 things. لَمْ تَظْهَرِ الْفَاحِشَةِ أَلَّنْ فَاحِشَةِ And wrongdoing doesn't spread. إِلَّا ظَهَرَ فِيهِمُ الطَّاعُونَ Is it plague? وَالْأَوْجَعَ Poverty. وَالْأَمْرَاضِ And illnesses. لَمْ تَكُنْ فِي أَسْلَافِهِمُ الَّذِينَ مَضَوْا Illnesses that the people before us never heard of. HIV. Stay away from zina. Don't commit zina. No, we're going to do it. Don't do it. Yep, we're going to do it. Okay, do it. Cure these illnesses now. They come. All the actors and their movie stars and their rapsters and their... they're finishing. Going, all of them. Why? Stay away from haram. You don't... Inshallah, the uquba will come. And it has no cure. Because Allah didn't bring a cure for it. And it will never tell them what the cure is. Because the cure is, stay away from it. That is the cure. They say use these things, and the head of NHS is trying to convince the people, do it, but do you use this? Use it. That's not the cure. They're not looking for the cure where it is. Islam haddadad dawa. It specified it and told us what it is. You have to look for it in the right place, brothers. Look for it in the right place. The second thing, getting rid of the thing that is harming you, Islam is taking it away from you. Let's place the three that we mentioned on the qalb and the heart, as this was the topic that we were talking about. The qalb, to protect it, its ability, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did He give you? Iman. Iman is the ability of the heart. Your car, without petrol, without oil, does it work? Your qalb cannot have ability at all without Iman. And we've said it miraran, wa nukarriru aydan miraran. We've said it many times, and inshallah we'll say it again, and again. Ibrahim ibn Adham, rahimahullahu wa li amthalihi rahmatan wasi'ah. They went to the side of the shore of the sea. When you look at the iman when it goes in your heart, tumaknina, tranquility, love, you're not worried. Other people are frustrated, they're there, but you're not. He took his bread, as he had a rough and hard bread, he dipped it in the sea. Him and his friend, Aba Yusuf. As he was dipping into the sea, Ibrahim ibn Adham said to him, Ya Aba Yusuf, Wallahi, لو علم الملوك وأبناء الملوك ما نحن فيه من النعيم والسرور لجادلون عليه بالسيوف. Wallahi, if the kings and the children of the kings were to know the ni'mah, the happiness that we have, Wallahi, they would go to their houses, get their swords out, and they would try to take it away from us. This is the happiness that we're in and the joy. That is a person who has quwwatul iman. When your qalb has quwwatul iman, brothers, when the people fall around, you don't fall. You don't fall. The battle of... In the battle of Ghazwatul Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that the people who did not fall because of the quwwah of their iman was the believers. وَإِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ Look at them. Marad. His heart is tainted. مَا وَعَدَنَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا The munafiqeen, whose heart was tainted, it had no quwwah, when they saw the army come, they said, Wallahi Muhammad and they fooled us and his Lord. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fooled us. Wallahi, their promise was nothing except a delusion, tricking us into all of this. He just wanted us to die. In another ayah, Allah reminded, أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُ يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتُ وَلَوْ كُنْتُ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيَّدًا Wallahi, death would come to you in your houses, even if your house is cement, bricks, stones, that will come to you wherever you are. Ah. They said, Wallahi, لو كنا نعلم قتالا لاتبعناكم. هم للكفر يومئذ أقرب للإيمان. Wallahi, Muhammad, if we were to know this is a jihad, we would have went with you. It wasn't a jihad, it was just a training match. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is what they did. They ran away. Or they started getting scared. Allah says about the believers, people who have quwwat al-iman. وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابِ. Just the same thing, but what these guys saw, each one saw. The difference is that each scene was different. Because the word didn't come from the lips only, brothers. It doesn't. The words come from the heart. لذلك, what did the Sha'ir say? He said, وَكُلُّ إِنَاءٍ بِالَّذِي فِيهِ يَنْضَحُ. Every well and every cup, it sweats what's inside it. You only sweat what's inside you. Have you seen if you eat food that's very... Some this type of food, if you eat, your sweat becomes bad, it smells bad. صح? Have you seen it? This type of food you should eat when you come to the masjid. Because of the sweat, it goes with the sweat. It then, your limbs only do what the heart is talking about. So what did they say? The believers are speaking from the heart. وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. When they saw the army, they said, wallahi, Allah and His Messenger have not promised us except the truth. تصديق مع تصديقين. وصدق الله, Allah has said the truth. And His Messenger have said the truth. Allah then says, when they said that, وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. The same place, come back to Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He spoke about the people of Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين. حفظ قوة الإيمان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did He send in the ayah? إِن تُبُدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوا يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. If you hide something in your hearts, or if it's on your limbs, Allah will hold you accountable. So if you think about a sin, you just think about it. بِمُجَرَّدِ الظَّنِّ وَالْ يُحَاسِبُكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ. Just the fact that you thought of doing a sin. مِنْ غَيْرِ عَمَلْ. Allah will hold you accountable. This is what the ayah said. The Sahabas, they said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ نَزَلَتْ مَا لَا نُطِيقُ وَاللَّهِ. The ayahs today that came down, Allah, we have no ability. Because wallahi, I can't stop what I think of. The evil that comes to my mind, I cannot stop it. I can stop it from not doing it, but I cannot stop thinking about it. What did they stop from? Remember we said, the person who's iman is what got? It's got, the person whose iman is salim, is sahih. Two things he has. Idraq al-ilm, al-idraq, to have ilm, knowledge. And the second one is tanfidh. Sah? To tanfidh is, goes back to the first one, sah, to have knowledge. The Prophet ﷺ said, do you not want to submit? Do you want to say what the Yahud said? أَتُرِيدُونَ أَن تَقُولُوا كَمَا قَالَتْ بِهِ بَنُوا إِسْرَائِيلِ. Which, what did they say? سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. We hear when we disobey. Is that what you want to say? قُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَطَعْنَا. Say we hear and we obey. فَمَا نَطَقُوا. They did not say it. They did not utter it. إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ آيَةُ التَّخْفِيفِ. Except the ayah of ease came down. لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Nobody's going to be burned for what they can't have, what they do. When did it come down, brothers? بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. After they acknowledged and they accepted it, even that though their mind was hard for them to accept. Brothers, somebody comes up to you and says, wallah, I can't pray Qiyamul Layl. Have you tried? Have you pushed yourself to it? And then after that, have you asked Allah? The Sahabas first, they couldn't take it. Prophet said, and submit first. You see a person say, wallah, can I tell you something? Yeah. I'm not the type of person who can memorize. I'm not the type of person. Of course, you will never be. Because you convinced yourself first. You told yourself that you can never learn the Quran. You told yourself that you can't achieve anything. You did. And the first enemy you have is yourself. Convince yourself opposite. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. Allah brought Ibn Taymiyyah. Allah brought Imam Malik and Imam Ahmed, Abu Sufyan, Sufyan al-Thawri, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Umar ibn al-Khattab. Each and every one of them, Allah brought them at the stomach of their mother not knowing anything. No one knew anything when they came out. Where did they pass each other? When they walked on this earth is where they passed each other. Determination was what part made people different. Not in the stomach. Ibn Taymiyyah never came out and said, قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى لَهُ. He didn't know nothing until when he came out, he set put his knees down and then he came with the determination once. The Prophet told the companions, don't go against Allah's call. Acknowledge it first. إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. هَذَا قَوْلِهِمُ الْخَالِدَةِ. That's the word that's ever going to remain, inshaAllah. Look at the ghazwa. The Prophet ﷺ said to the Sahabas, what should we do today? They wanted to fight in the city of Medina. And who owned Medina? Who owned Medina? Ansar, Al-Aws and Khazraj were the two biggest clans. They owned it. The Prophet ﷺ spoke. فقام رجل من الأنصار من المهاجرين. One of the people of Muhajirin stood up. He said, Ya Rasul, wallahi inna la ma'akum. Wallahi ya Rasul, we're going to help you. The Prophet didn't want the Muhajirin to talk. He didn't want to hear that. Because the city is not theirs. So he went quiet. One of the men from the Ansar stood up. He said, Ya Rasul, ka'annaka turiduna. It's like you want us. He said, no. Today is the day of Ansar. I need to hear Ansar talk. Why? Because the blood that sheds today and the people who get harmed today is most going to be your people. And the land that we're going to fight from and the houses that are going to go down is the houses of Ansar. Today we need you to talk. Ansar said, Wallahi, look at the call of these Sahabis. They said, Ya Rasulullah, la naqul lakum kama qalat bani Israel li Musa. Wallahi, we're not going to see, say what? Ansar, alaykum salam. Wallahi, the messenger of Allah, we're not going to say to you what the Yahud said to their Prophet Ibrahim, when they were Musa. What did they say to him? They said, اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إن هاهنا قاعدون. You and your Lord go, we will fight. We'll wait for you guys. We'll just wait for the result. You and Allah go. لكن نقول لك, we say to you, اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إن معكما قاتلون. You and Allah go and fight, and we're going to be right beside you, fighting beside you. We're not going to wait. That was what the Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين ولاهم. Saw the haq, they accepted it. Allah protected their hearts for them. Gave them ziyadah to be iman. To accept the haq and to acknowledge the haq and to strive to the haq. I ask Allah tabarakhu ta'ala. Today is a day of his years. A day he owns subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna iddata shuhuri inda Allah ifna ashara shahra fi kitabillah. The days of the year is owned by Allah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our qulub firm on his religion. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي he used to say but I will say ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وطاعتك اللهم ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وطاعتك وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله عليه وسلم على سيدنا محمد.